What's up, everybody? Sorry about the silence. Just wanted to make sure we were actually streaming. There's going to be a lot less of these awkward me staring down startups very soon. I'm working on getting a PC set up. It's actually one that my fiance started a while ago and never finished, and we're essentially doing a trade. I'm going to be doing some more Mario stuff. Let me make sure I just grab the right file. Yep. Okay. I had a brain fart which one I actually had. The first two things I want to try to pull off in this stream is I want to get the metal cap switch, because I have the other two. And I want to take down the second Bowser. First I'm going to be going after the metal cap, and then I'll open up the Dry Docks world and go after Bowser. And is it this one? Nope. I've actually been playing the DS version of this thing recently, and it's weird going back to this one after a couple of days of that, because the DS one on the touchscreen on the bottom, you actually get the map of where you are, so you can kind of see a little bit better of where you need to go. Another big difference I'm noticing from the DS version is in that version they actually made it so for you to actually full-on sprint, there's a button you need to hold. Like, just pressing the joystick in one direction will set you on like a fast walk. It's weird. I'm actually going to have to stop playing the DS one right before I do this one, because the differences are kind of wonky. It's got to be that door then. Yes, I know there's a star there, but like I said, I want to get the cap first. I'm actually going to go get on this thing's head. Make this a little bit easier for myself. This is the correct door. Hopefully. Once you step on the cap switch, the green blocks will become solid, blah blah blah. What's up, PewDiePie? How's it going? guess I'll save. See if I can get the red coins while I'm here. Might as well pop off this star. That's right, there's two over there. Guess I want the extra life. Well, welcome to the channel. I'm going back in time a little bit. Back out there to the caps box, get the last few stars, stay on the fucking platform, Mario, thank you. Alright, we got 6, we got 7, bazinga. Alright, star number 35, welcome to the club. Now, let's go open up Dry Dry Docks, and then let's go kill Bowser. At least his second form. I always forget about this one having its own little separate world first. It's coming along. This is, I think, the third or fourth stream I've done. If I counted correctly when I titled the stream, it should be the fourth one. So far I'm going off of memory, but, when I intro'd this series, I actually mentioned how everything past, like, this Bowser, I've either never played or I've played it through, like, friends' files, so I've never actually had to get the later stars. So it's gonna be interesting after I clear out the lower floor once I get up to the tower. I think my other favorite feature from the DS version of this game is they actually have I think it's the left trigger button on that one. It snaps the camera behind you, so if you're trying to set up like a straight run, it's easier to get the camera aimed properly. But this is what I was talking about, how it's the separate world first, and then you get to go after Bowser. And I always fuck up this platform. Very surprised at myself that I did not touch the lava. No, get the hell away from me. never remember which way actually gets to Bowser, if they kind of fork and come back to each other. No. That's right, I should. Nah. I think I'll make a separate run in here for the red stars, because I always have issues going after this Bowser, at least getting to him. So yeah, we will come back for the red coins. Going to take the extra life. And that's another thing I always forget. I forget that's an elevator platform. Really? Thank you for not letting me know that I can't see the top. There we go. Much better. Alright, what do we got? Long jump. No. This thing is so hard to time. Ha. Alright, that'll give me some time to think. Alright, so if I head off this way. Bam. Come on. There we go. I'm fully shocked that I haven't died. I always have trouble getting to this Bowser. Give me the fucking bomb. No, shit. That was my own stupid fault to try to ride the lava. Take two. Oh shit. That's not good. Come on. Okay. That's right, we need to go this way, anyways. Yahoo! Actually, I don't think I even need to go up there, do I? No, I don't. That's right. Go down. Thank you. Hopefully, I don't fuck this one up again. And of course, shit. Come on, land. There we go. Hell yeah. I know it's not the most perfect way to do it, but got the job done. Shit. There we go. See if I can pull this off. There we go. Ha! Alright, now the easy part. I just gotta throw Bowser into a bomb. He gets some new attacks this time, too. No. Shit. He stops for a lot longer in the DS version. What? I don't remember the invincibility. No. Can you stop blinking? Jesus. Come on. You gonna jump? You're not gonna jump? Oh shit. Come on. Alright, got a straight shot, it's just the timing. Nope, strike two. Ugh. Come on. I hate the aiming for throwing Bowser. This is, yeah, this is like the worst thing for me in this game. Nope. Alright, you're gonna have to blink back out here. I'm not running off the edge. If I fuck this up, I think I need to, like, retire from gaming. Ha! Alright, so we get the key to the top floor. I think I'll pop back into the Bowser world and try to get the 8 red coins now. Just while I'm here and I've been playing the world. Now it's just a matter of finding them all. Crap. I didn't even touch the platform, so I didn't even make it start. There we go. Okay. At least it's doable without the platform. They weren't complete douchebags about that. Yup, that's my own fault. Sir, nope. Alright, well, I'm gonna drop. There we go. I fully deserve that. Oh, we got two. I'll actually start the platform this time. Take two on the red coins. Let's go. Shit. How do I get that one? Ah, wait. Obviously, there's this one here. Of course, I would miss that. Take Don't care. Do what I needed to do. Is that the fourth one? Yeah, fourth one. Wow, I got fucking lucky. Nothing stupid over on one of these little pillars, is there? Nope. Alright, cool. Oh wait, is there a snap button? Not really. Three more to get. I haven't seen the next one yet, and that somewhat worries me. But I know there's this whole section up top. Two more. I think and I hope that the star container, I think it's at the end before you're supposed to drop down into the pipe. Hoping I'm remembering that correctly. How is this fucking bomb so hard to grab? I feel like I swiped through him like four times. Alright, there's one all the way at the end. Alright. Final coin, where the hell are you? Down there? Or are you up top? You are right down there. Just make sure I'm not dropping into something stupid. Kind of am, but. Ah! Haha. Oh fuck, it's all the way up there. Baby steps. Bazinga. There we go. 37. Alright. Don't need to take down Bowser again. So that's that. Alright. Well, I know I need the last star for Jolly Roger Bay. And I also know that I need, I think it's 50 or 60, it's gotta be 50, for, the last Bowser. I don't think this is gonna be. No, it's not gonna get me there in time. It'd be nice. Not gonna happen though. Nope. Alright, where's the other metal cap in here? Set it up on that platform. Yep, alright. Should be able to long jump this and pretty much fall down where I need to. Hopefully. Probably not. Ha! Perfect time. Alright. Okay, so that is it for the worlds on this part of the castle. So now we need to go downstairs and actually start clearing out these worlds. Where do I want to go first? I think I'll hit... See, it's always hard for me to choose these ones because I like all of them. I'll go with the cave for now. Gotta go back down and see Nessie in the pit, so... And, of course, I chose the wrong fucking door again. I don't know why I always do that. Alright. We go this way. Nope. Nope. Don't fuck this up, Mario. And damage. That's fine. Because I've always loved that about this game, that if you take any damage, literally all you have to do is just find water to go underneath. And then as soon as you surface, it all heals. It's definitely a useful thing when, especially when you're going after the 100 coins, because, you know, if you've got only a couple left to get, you're not going to be finding many coins to heal yourself with anyways. So it's nice that you can kind of just like dip in the water and dip back out and you're good to go. Bring me to the star. Bring me to the star. So I'm thinking, yeah, I'm actually going to jump ahead really quick. I'm supposed to be going for the red coins, obviously, but I always have issues with the, see, now I'm confusing it with the DS version. Yeah, fuck it, I'll just go in order. Uh, Because in the DS version, there's two stars in the cave. And I think they're both in this one, too. Yeah, they have to be. Because, yeah, I just remember the extra one that they put in for the DS version. Because what they did for the DS version was they kept it all the same. But there are a number of... There's one extra star in each world. They're kind of all specific to... You need a specific character to get them. I would fuck that up. And no. Bad spider. Bad spider. Bad touch. Whatever. You're leaving me alone now. And in this world on the DS version, if I can actually make this jump. Thank you. That hallway that I was in before I came in here, where the boulders are falling down, you actually have to, because they add in, they take away the caps, and they add in Luigi, Wario, and Yoshi. And instead of the three separate caps, there's... there's a red box which spits out a flower, and the power you get is different for each character you play. And so Mario becomes like this balloon essentially that you can float around, which I think is supposed to still be the wing cap, kind of. Luigi becomes the vanishing one. He can walk through the fences and stuff. And Wario becomes the metal cat. I still don't know what Yoshi's does, because as soon as I don't need him anymore, I kind of always stop using him. Oh, come on. Well, at least now I just have to worry about lining up to get the coin. Platform's a pain in the ass. It's always the fucking the simple shit in this game. The stuff that's supposed to be simple that ends up being more frustrating to do. Hopefully, third time's a charm. Alright. They're all easy from here. All the rest of the red coins are so much easier. Now, we just get to ride around on a platform. And hopefully not fuck this up. right. Now we just have to get there and there. Bam. What's next? Is it the Hazy Maze Cave? Oh yeah. Okay. Okay, I got you. Oh, come on. That was my fault. Thank you. I didn't want to get squished again. Give me. Give. Back down to the cave. If I seem like that, I assure you it's complete bullshit. pretty much anything and everything I know about this game comes from the fact that I have been playing it since I was 8. And I've played a couple of the different versions of it. PewDiePie just asked me if I knew any lore behind this game. But yeah, no, that's pretty much the straight up honest answer is no. I just happen to know what I know from my own experiences. I don't really dive into the mythology and lore and stuff behind a lot of games. They have to like really, really pull me in for me to do that. So like there are a few that I could go spend hours and hours talking about. Like, honestly, Dead Space is one of the harder ones for me to shut up about. Where did we go? Alright, I'm pretty sure I actually just got the wrong star. Well, going for the wrong star. But was there anything specific you were looking to ask me about with this game, or are you just curious how deep the knowledge went? Yeah, sorry, then that's all I got for you. I'm trying to think, though. I know, I'm assuming you've played this one before. Do you know the penguin race on the on Cool Cool Mountain? Oh, never played any N64 games? Well, you, sir, are missing, like, the greatest piece of gaming history. Well, then, you need this in your situation. I actually, me and one other person are covering the N64 on our YouTube channels. Completely by chance, honestly. I started it up to have fun, so I had a reason to go back to this console. And he had actually started it, like, sometime earlier last year. Yeah, no, we're going through the console, every game, in order of release, and, yeah, no, I would, if you'd like, I would definitely check it out. He's a little bit further ahead than I am, but it's so much fun to go back to this console, and this really is, like, a huge, huge, huge part of gaming history. Like, I can't stress that enough. The N64 definitely has some classics. And, like, the cool thing, too, is... How do I get there? I'm having a dirt moment right now. Now the cool thing is a lot of, like, the really, really popular N64 games, they've gotten remade for newer stuff, but they still can't top, going back to these original cartridges. Like, even considering how much better, you know, graphics are and all that kind of stuff today, there's certain genres and series and stuff that I would much rather play the older N64 version, just because it still holds up and it's still that good. So it's not that one. Where the fuck am I supposed to go? I always have issues going for the star, especially after playing the DS version, because in the DS version, like I said, there's the different power-ups, and sorry, I'm spacing out trying to not die. Mario's power with turning into a balloon, like, completely negates the point of this maze. Because you can literally just float up to wherever you need to go. Thank you. Like, you can literally just turn into a balloon and float to wherever the fuck you need to go. And, like, that's not the point of the mazes. You're supposed to get lost and not suffocate on the toxic gas. I will definitely have to check that out. I think I mentioned at the top of the video, I'm gonna be getting a PC set up in the near future. So I will definitely have to bookmark that site. Thank you very much. Watch for rolling rocks. What the fuck? What is this one? Oh boy. I'm having a massive brain fart on what the hell this star is. Nope, that wasn't it. What the hell? I might actually have to pop online really quick for this one. Oh god. Pokemon on a PC, that's dangerous. I have to, like, hide my own handheld copies of Pokemon or else I just get lost. Where the fuck is this one? Oh wow, that actually saves space. That's pretty cool. Alright, then it's less dangerous, but still. Pokemon on a PC. You would think that the star would be here because the rocks are here. Wow, what makes the controls hard to control? You'll have to pardon me, I'm actually asking Google what the hell I'm supposed to do, because I don't remember this star, and I don't know why, but I'm under the impression that there's a platform to jump on behind where, like, where the rocks fall down. Yep, I was right. Somewhat. Oh. Wait, what do you do? Oh, it is on the other side. See, that's completely different from what they did in the DS version, which is actually, I've been playing that one over the weekend. That one was not in the DS version. Alright. So all I have left to do in there is get the 100 coins, and because of how minute the task is of getting all of those coins, I'm actually going to do the 100 coin treks offline. Just because... It's mainly because of the issues that I had getting them in the Bomb Battlefield, where I had to like search and search and search just to get them. So just to kind of cut down on wasting that time. I'm actually going to go ahead and cheat for, well, not cheat really, but I'm skipping ahead on a star. Give me land. No. Alright. Peter Guy, if you answered, I missed it. The last one I had from you was just saying that they were hard to control. I had to back out and check on how to get the star that I just got in the Hazy Maze Cave. So I apologize. Why did I do that? That was stupid. Nope. Shouldn't have even tried that. I've got like 10, maybe 15 minutes left where I can get away with playing. I'm hoping I can hit the 50 stars right now. I have a grooming appointment for my dog, which I have to leave for very shortly. There we go. So yeah, if I can hit the 50 stars, and I'm actually gonna, right now, I'm gonna go take a minute to go run up to the tower and check that I actually need 50 to get through that door. Because if that's the case, then I will try to hit 50 right now, and then the next stream, I will take down the last Bowser, and then I can just focus on getting all the stars. Up, 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 up. Where's staircase? Am I going the wrong way? Yeah, I almost looked the wrong way. Alright, we need 50. Alright, so we will pop off the last four. And I think there's an easy one in here somewhere. There's supposed to be like two of these toads that you can find that he just gives you a star. Is it him if I talk to him a second time? Nope. Is it this one in the mirror? Maybe. I thought there was a toad in here. Nope. Hey, welcome to the stream. I am vaping a blueberry juice that's made from my local vape shop. Nothing too fancy. Is it the one under the staircase? You, sir, or ma'am, I'm going to assume sir, though, are a gentleman and a scholar. Thank you. Hey, hey, welcome to the stream, Pum Gum Gum. Alright, I'm going back downstairs in the basement. Trying to hit 50 before I hop off here. Give me 1 second, I have to message my fiance really quickly. Yeah. I'm actually playing this off my N64 too. This is the controller I got for my 8th birthday, so somehow it's managed to survive 20 years. This way. And I'm actually going to go back inside the entrance for the Hazy Maze Cave because. Ha! That's awesome. Aren't 8th birthdays the greatest? I have the OG gray one somewhere. I think it's upstairs still. But now I've got this one, the gray one, and then my fiance has the red one, which is of course slightly out of reach, so I can't show it on camera right now. Like, I like the look of the gray one. Just because of that, you know, classic Nintendo nostalgia, but even when I was a kid, like, this one just feels better for me. Now, Let's get a couple of stupid stars before I have to hop off stream. Shit. Alright, one down. There we go, and then big bitch should come out. There we go. Honestly, it whacks pretty good. I probably stopped using this one for about a decade, because my parents are split. And I had this at my dad's house, and I was only ever there, like, alternate weekends and shit. And then when I stopped going there after I hit college, he kind of, like, packed it up and put it up in the attic. And then, I want to say 4 or 5 years ago now, is when I got it back. So, out of the 20 years, it hasn't gotten an actual 20 years of usage, if that makes any sense. Yes, PewDiePie, you're missing out a little bit. Everyone's gonna yell at you. Especially if they know the N64 personally. No, do not, you piece of shit. Officially hit 50. So I'm going to call this one a day for now. I'll probably be back on with this one specifically next Monday morning, same time around 10 a.m. Eastern time. And I'll kick that one off with taking down the final Bowser, which is actually something I've never done before. I've never actually beaten the final Bowser in this game. So, But yeah, that will do it for this stream. Thank you for the few people that popped in. Hope you enjoyed it. And yeah, again, I will be back with this one next Monday, and this Wednesday I'll actually be streaming my new exclusive game for the month, which is going to be Rise of the Tomb Raider, which, again, something else that is slightly out of reach and I can't show it on camera now. But that will be Wednesday, starting 10 a.m. in the morning, and then 7 p.m. at night. So I will hopefully see you guys soon, and take care and game on, guys.